Welcome back to Small Wagons! Yay! This time I'm in the driver's seat. We're all doomed.
Well, technically, he's been in the driver's seat the whole time. He's the first character in the driver's seat.
A technicality, nothing more. Anyway, give me an adventure. Come on, skip the intro screen, we've seen it X times.
I didn't like the little picture, but you know how these screens make round them like it's a CRT.
I don't think it's the day we write the animals gets lower as we go on.
I don't know. I don't really just want, like, there's nothing bullshit, random bullshit in this game, it's just weird. Which I have had, and that's about
it. Posse of bandits. Don't go with a bullet to the face. So just like, name that sort of dungeon.
Bullet out of hell. Speaking of dungeon, Artist is probably going to try against the building
stuff. Good. I was just a machine gun arm. I was going to say, because our the thumbnail of the dungeon has been a bit boring.
Yeah, well,
I've just... Okay, bullet to the head for me.
So I
never liked it. I knew that was a dungeon. Yes. All left
to look for wild berries. No, but I saw a few.
Entrance to a cave. Watch the cave.
I think spider cave or back cave.
No. Spider cave. Very dark inside. It was full of bacon.
This game used to be...
Oh, look, there's a bunch of ammo.
Why?
Okay.
I had the brilliant idea, yeah.
Because... Jump.
Running
start,
I'm not
going to
start. No, it did say the wagon.
Run safely, conveniently. Great Plains. Buffalo. Now let's see what happens. Buffalo versus AK-47. That's what happens. Wreckage, wagon, buffalo.
Game over.
Anyone?
I wish this was on the arcade machine that we played, the retro from that.
Yeah.
Playing Punch-Out was pretty fun. It wasn't until I noticed everybody else had kind of left and I felt really bad because I knew,
I think at that point, me and Rohan were still sat on the other side of the room seeing who could do better at Tetris.
Oh, is that what you...
I saw Mike Tyson punch out, and I played this before. So I finally played this game. What the hell is this? It causes poison.
There's three circuits and then Mike Tyson. I literally, within like 10 minutes, managed to TKO everybody in the first and second circuit in the first round.
TKO.
And a friend came out like, dude, you got a proper game first of all. I'm like, I feel this game a bit too much. Can you not tell?
Guns and ammo!
We've
got 15 rocket launcher ammo. River crossing. Jump! Let's see if we can take these rocket launchers and go into orbit.
We're going to orbit!
Yes! We've got a rocket launcher and we're in orbit!
This is how you do it. The satellite in the world.
Pass through a meteor shower. You know, I'm sure movies say this shouldn't work. I mean, physics says this shouldn't work.
physics say that you should be able to do an airstrike in space? What we did?
A strange machine.
Oh look, it's it's a satellite. I couldn't think of a better deal.
Why do you want to hold it? Landed on the same room that they jumped over the place. Yes! We unlocked the space shuttle. And we've still got 6 missiles left. And now we get to go hunt off one with our rocket launcher. Missile launcher. I'm not sure what the difference is.
I don't think there is a difference. I mean, Resi 3, Resi again,
we'll
go with the rocket launcher.
Yeah. Well, this is terrible.
Yeah,
this is terrible for hunting buffalo.
Why is there only you with an empty escort? I didn't even realize anybody had died.
Oh yeah.
No, I mean, they don't forget to come up with the text.
Yeah.
I didn't. Brian was just by Bison.
The party's already ended, bloody blah, buffaloes.
We unlocked the space shuttle.
I was going to say, I assume we've got this one with the time. Let's load up our space shuttle and head for wagons, okay? Our trusty wagon. The motherfucking space shuttle.
The fast. How quickly?
Not sure. Oh, it's day 4!
We've got a spaceship. And
we need to restock the lamp.
We've just got the bits of the wagon on the spaceship.
Posse of bandits! And we're all dead.
A lot of people always get that mistaken,
The 20th and 21st century, the 20th century was 1900 to 2000, the 21st century is where we are now.
Yeah, I know. But everybody thinks 2000 was the 21st century, No. It's after 2000. It's the 20th century.
Because the year 0 to 100 was the first century.
Yeah.
So you work forward from there. Yeah, it's not really all that important.
No.
I mean, it's just an arbitrary limit measurement.
Oh, why have we only got 2 hearts?
I don't know. Sorry, I wasn't looking.
We've only got 2 hearts.
I was distracted by stuff over here. Oh, we're doomed. Is this, this will be the special ability of the space shuttle.
What?
You start the game with 2 hearts.
I think the game is faster, but you get 2 hearts.
There are lots of squirrels. This is how you hunt squirrels.
Next performance, my face. A Tommy gun!
Missiles, got machine guns.
We've
got a gun to the head. You shouldn't let things like this go to your head.
No, I
shouldn't. Throw down the building in death after being shot. Yeah. Okay, what am I going to die from this gun?
Bears!
Okay, I've got flamethrower, so let's cheat. There we go. Back to the wagon. River Crossing, and now we'll have the blue idea to do something incredibly stupid. Can I afford to afford it? No, so let's jump. Leap.
I'm sure for us, we've got a spell of a J.
No, that's fuel. That's a kind of cliff, river. I don't know what the word is.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, I know exactly what you mean. But it's, the fjords are a specific geographical,
I'm sorry, I just said a bear sharp and we want to make a note of like party things.
No. Anyway, yeah. So a fording is where there's a shallow part of the river you can cross over. A fjord is where a river goes into a sea, usually in Denmark, Norway, Sweden. It's usually describing the rock formations. A big cliff, really cool looking. I say with no prejudice whatsoever.
Well, the other one would be to Sweden.
Exactly, that's why I'm saying with no prejudice whatsoever. Just because part of my family's Swedish.
I'm not working with Irish.
Yeah, I know.
You've been doing that whole time.
No, I don't. Yeah, we do. Yeah. Insert Guinness joke here. Yeah, I just can't be honest making you joke about it right now.
I think I love these
things,
bro.
Neither can I. Yeah, I know you do. Animals!
I need the iron.
Throw the iron in.
Yeah.
Oh, nice!
Anyone in the barbecue?
It kills the skunk without them smelling it.
Well, I bet I wouldn't pick this smell on death.
Posse of Bandits!
I can't believe we live at 1200, I'm not about 100. As far as a
I died from what it proposed.
Unless the eye. Alright, it's probably just got this. Is it even,
I was going to say that the bullet helmet is rather familiar.
Well, I was going to say also the landing is like, oh, this is happening, this is happening, this is happening.
Okay.
I mean, it's just multiple runs rather than...
Yeah, well, I'll see. Yeah, I'll just say, as a straight-up comparison, this and Dungeon are much of a similar style.
Whereas this, I think it's a bit more faster-paced, more runs.
And I think this has more random humour.
Yes, it does.
Whereas Dungeon has a bit more straight-up humour.
Dungeon is just,
Gundry.
Can we get time?
Yeah.
Next time
I think I'll take the standard dragons.
What, so we can get more hearts?
Yes.
We move
slower, but we have 4 more. Animals in a clearing. Yeah, the 1851 call. You choking the door to hell.
We must have a couple of special rocks. There's a reference to it in Gunny.
Almost anything Gunny related, there's a reference to it in Gunny.
And because they had the call on this before the 1851, very specifically 1851. Any game I've ever got,
Resident Evil's Cult Python is, Resident Evil's Cult Python anyway.
No, but what I like is about the
My favourite new game plus weapon for a Resident game is in Resident 4, the Chicago Cult Python.
I don't remember that.
Once you complete the game, looking in the cave. You complete the game and then you can buy it from the shopkeep for a million.
Oh yeah.
It has unlimited ammo though.
Oh, that's cool.
And it's a power of 10. And you can reload, but you just get a cool animation, especially when you're wearing the gangster outfit. Because you do the...
Yeah,
And then if you've done 10 reloads, then you throw the hat into the air and catch it and jam it into your hand. A bear 8 foot.
A bear 8 foot. I can't do that.
No,
I remember the little
Viper outfit
in Resi 2.
Oh, yeah.
That was...
Yeah, the two outfits I can remember from Resi 4 it's one outfit for each. Leon gets outfits and Ashley gets outfits. Leon's outfits are his Resi 2 police uniform and the Chicago
Ashley
gangster. Ashley's is the stripper and the armor.
Yeah, the armor's more useful.
Yes, it is. that's where I'm finally going to get around to doing a run on the professional mode job. I'm going to do it with the armor just to make that one little bit easier. Doc Salvador cuts your head off with a chainsaw. If he does that and your head happens to roll so that your eyes are facing up underneath her,
oh, no.
She does the exact same thing. I mean, you'd think her priorities at that point would be a bit different, but...
Yeah, you're
dead! Yes, exactly.
No, but she's so pathetic, like, there's times when I get that annoyed.
Oh, you got green fever. Green
with envy. There's times
when
I get that annoyed that I've left, you know, the enemy's carrying you off for a bit while I kill the rest of them. Like, no, fuck you! You get gift kept up, I quit! President, you don't get any job actually, you're a little dick, because you want to stay where I tell her to. Right, stay here while I go fight these guys. I'm gonna follow you and get captured!
Yeah. Yes, her ability at getting captured by the enemies is quite astonishing.
The thing is, well, actually, some of them are pretty much her size, not smaller, and they still pick her up!
Well, they cheat, they have strength boosting parasites, remember? The parasites, the spliggers, are slaves to my will! I can complete control.
You get about another 2 hours and then you become,
then you become a giant flower.
Yes, because you fucked up. Kind of like Wesker
then. I'm dispatching my right hand to deal with your right hand comes out. I mean, when I first played it, I played that scene, I was like, probably 14. And that line just, you know, knocked me down with laughter. I don't know why, because it's not actually all that good a joke, but it's just...
Who
can forget the Jill sandwich?
I'm annoyed you took an hour to do the remake.
Yay! I killed all the bats and nicked all their skins. Almost all their skins.
I was really upset when
the remake, you
took the Jill sandwich out. You took out... Like, what was the cheesy voice acting wasn't the best way? It worked. Yeah.
We made it
as a weapon. It's really powerful, especially against living things. No shit, man. Well, to be fair,
it's suitable for you, the master of unlocking. The master of unlocking.
Take it really.
Yes.
Against living things, we also made a human attack, basically not use it against zombies. It's more useful against the hunters and yawn. Was the yawn fighting at the IR remake? I can't remember.
I don't know. I've never actually finished Resi 1.
What, even the original?
I mean, I've got actually every Resi game in the queue, but I finished 3, 4, I think 2, and I got most of the way through Veronica, and then I found my cheat code disc and started messing around with some, like, the first person game.
Right.
Which felt really weird for
us. I think we'll have to continue the next one.
Yeah. Oh, we're out of time.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I'm rewind.
I'm gone.
And we're out of here.